You are listening to Audio SSLC, your audio medium for easy understanding and revision. To download a copy of this recording, please visit audiossslc.com.
Unit 11, Indian Natural Disasters. We learn the following in this chapter. Meaning of natural disasters. Causes, effects and distribution of cyclones, floods, landslides, coastal erosion, earthquakes in India. Meaning of natural disasters. The natural hazards which create widespread destruction are known as natural disasters. Disasters may be natural or man-made. Natural disasters can be geological hazards such as earthquakes, volcanoes, tsunamis, landslides and avalanches. The weather-associated natural disasters are cyclones, drought, floods and epidemics. Most natural disasters are infrequent and unpredictable. However, a better knowledge about them could reduce the extent of damage. India is a vast country and has been facing various natural disasters, that is, cyclones, floods, landslides, coastal erosion, earthquakes, etc. 1. Cyclones. In a cyclone, the wind blows spirally inwards towards the center of low pressure. This disaster is associated with the atmosphere. There are two types of cyclones, namely tropical cyclones and temperate cyclones. Tropical cyclones are more common in India. Causes. The most ideal conditions for the origin and development of tropical cyclones are number 1. High temperature, number 2. Calm air, and number 3. Highly saturated air. These conditions result in the development of low pressure center, that is depression. Relative high pressure provides around the low pressure. So the winds blow spirally inwards the center of low pressure, causing cyclones. Such conditions are found in tropical zone, especially over the seas. Effects. Tropical cyclones are very destructive to cause loss of life and property, damage to buildings, transports and communication system, disrupt power supply, destroy crops, vegetation, animals, etc. Distribution. In India, most of the tropical cyclones develop in the Bay of Bengal. Hence, the eastern coast is more prone to cyclones. It includes the coastal areas of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and West Bengal. Only a few cyclones develop in the Arabian Sea. Tropical cyclones occur mainly in India during the northeast monsoon season. October and November are known for severe cyclones. Few cyclones occur in the month of May and June. Preventive measures. Cyclones are natural phenomenon. We cannot prevent them. But people can pay heed to the warnings. They should keep in touch with radio, television and other communicative lines. Temporary shelters should be provided during cyclones. Cyclone-proof structures can be constructed. Mangrove forests and other deep-rooted trees can be grown along the coastline to check the impact of cyclonic winds and the soil erosion. Number 2. Floods. Flood refers to the inundation of land by river water. It is a recurring disaster in India. One part of the country or the other has to face floods almost every year. Causes. Floods are caused by both natural and man-made factors. The natural factors include heavy rainfall, melting of snow, tropical cyclones, cloudburst, blockage of the free flow of river water and silting riverbeds, etc. The man-made causes are deforestation, faulty irrigation and agricultural practices, breaching of barrages and rapid urbanization. Effects. 1. Floods causes loss of life and property. 2. Damage to crops, vegetation, etc. 3. Breakdown of communication and power system. 4. Dislocation of transport system. 5. Soil erosion, disruption of essential services, etc. Flood-prone areas. 1. The Ganga and the Brahmaputra river basins. They cover a part of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal and Assam. 2. The Satluj, the Bees, the Ravi and Chenab river basins. They include Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh. 3. In peninsular India, the deltaic areas of river basins, that is, deltaic regions of Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri rivers. They include Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. 4. The lower parts of Narmada and Tapi river basins, that is, Gujarat. In peninsular India, floods are occasional. They are due to sudden heavy rainfall. Flood control measures. 1. Afforestation in the catchment area, which helps in the reduction of runoff. 2. Construction of dams across the rivers and storing of water in reservoirs. It reduces the volume of water and helps to provide water for irrigation, etc. 3. Construction of embankments for protection against inundation of the inhabited areas and agricultural land. 4. Flood forecasting and early warnings. This is essential for taking timely action to prevent loss of human life, livestock and property. Number 3. Landslides. The sliding of landmass along steep slopes of hills or mountains is called landslides. It involves downward sliding or falling of a mass of soil, rock and debris or combination of these under the force of gravity. Causes. Both natural and human-induced forces cause landslides. Natural forces. Undercutting of the slope as in sea wave erosion of a sea cliff, earthquakes and heavy rainfall. Human forces. Deforestation. Construction of roads, railway lines, dams and reservoirs, hydropower projects, mining, quarrying, etc. Effects. Landslides are destructive natural disasters. Major effects are blocking of roads, railway lines, burying of human settlements and vegetation, loss of life and property, etc. Roads blocking is a very common problem. Distribution. In India, landslides occur very often in hilly states like Jammu, Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and northeast states. Preventive measures. Slope reduction. Prevention of rock falls along highways and other slopes. Avoiding of mining and quarrying activities near the steep slopes and human settlement and buildings. There should be massive reforestation, etc. steps to reduce the occurrence of landslides. Number 4. Coastal erosion. Sea waves strike the coasts with great force. This constant process leads to erosion of coasts. Hence, coastal erosion is the process of wearing away and removal of materials along the coastline by wave action. Causes and distribution. Coastal erosion is mostly caused by sea waves and ocean currents. In India, the causes are 1. Monsoon winds, 2. Tropical cyclones, and 3. Tsunamis. 1. The southwest monsoon. The southwest monsoon winds causes intensive coastal erosion along the west coast of India. During this season, the coasts of Gujarat, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu are largely affected by coastal erosion. 2. Tropical cyclone. They are destructive and mostly occur during the northeast monsoon season over the Bay of Bengal. They cause serious coastal erosion along the east coast of India, including the coastal areas of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. 3. Tsunamis. Tsunamis are large waves generated by earthquakes. The coastal erosion occurs due to tsunamis in India. Andaman Nicobar Islands and east coast of India have been affected by tsunamis. Do you know? Groins. a series of groins including huge rock masses or concrete logs. These are placed at right angles to the shorelines to reduce the coastal erosion. Next, there are breakers. It's a barrier built into sea to check the impact of waves and protect the coast. Human interference also helps in coastal erosion. Removal of sand and construction of breakwater are the main causes. Effects. Coastal erosion is one of the natural disasters. 1. Coastal areas, including trees and buildings, can be washed away. 2. The roads, railway lines, bridges, etc. along the coast can be damaged. 3. Coastal areas can remain flooded over a long period of time, requiring resettlement of people. Preventive measures. 1. Constructing seawalls, groins, and breakwaters to protect the coastal areas from wave erosion. 2. Restrict sand mining in coastal areas. 3. Planting of trees to stabilize the beaches and coastal dunes. Number 5. Earthquakes. An earthquake is a violent vibration in the Earth's crust. It is one of the worst natural hazards which often results in disaster. Causes. Earthquake occurs due to several causes such as plate movements, volcanic eruption, faulting and folding, landslides, collapse of underground cave roofs, hydrostatic pressure of man-made water bodies like reservoirs, etc. In India, most of the earthquakes that have occurred earlier were due to plate movement. Effects. The disastrous effects of earthquakes are cracking of ground surface, damage and destruction of buildings, rails, roads, power lines, telecom lines, bridges, dams, factories, loss of human and animal lives and property. The other effects are fires, landslides, disturbance in groundwater level, blockage and diversion of river course, destruction of forests due to fires, etc. Distribution. There are three major earthquake zones in India. 1. The Himalayan zone. This zone includes the states of Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. It is a zone of maximum intensity. The earthquakes in this zone are basically due to plate tectonics, that is in Chamoli and Uttarakashi. 2. The Indo-Gangetic zone. It lies to the south of the Himalayas. It comprises of Rajasthan, plains of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. This zone is called, in quotes, the zone of moderative intensity. 3. The Peninsular zone. It includes the islands of Lakshadweep, Andaman and Nicobar, and Ran of Kutch. Peninsular India had been considered as a stable landmass. Only a few earthquakes have been occurred in this zone, mostly in recent years. Therefore, it is known as, in quotes, zone of minimum intensity. Precautionary measures. 1. Avoid the human settlements in the earthquake-prone zones. 2. Follow earthquake-resistant designs for the construction of buildings. 3. Use building materials of high quality and avoid high-rise buildings. 4. Restrict the over-groundwater mining. 5. Restrict urban growth in the hilly areas with high seismic vulnerability. 6. Avoid the construction of large dams and reservoirs. 7. Stop deforestation and heavy quarrying activities. Besides, post-disaster measures after earthquakes are also essential, that is, relief, recovery, rehabilitations. Exercises. Fill in the blanks. Number 1. The most destructive atmospheric disaster is dash. 2. In India, the eastern coast is more prone to dash. 3. In peninsular India, dash occur occasionally. 4. In India, dash occur very often in hilly states. 5. Coastal erosion is mostly caused by dash action. Next, discuss in groups and answer. Number 1. What are natural disasters? Give example. 2. What are floods? Mention the natural causes of floods. 3. What is a cyclone? Mention their major effects. 4. Explain the causes and effects of landslides. 5. Write about causes and distribution of coastal erosion in India. 6. Mention the precautionary measures to be taken to reduce the effects of earthquakes. In the activities, number 1, draw an outline map of India and mark the flood-prone areas and cyclone-prone areas. 2. List out the most destructive earthquake in India during the last 100 years. In the project work, collect photographs of natural disaster and prepare an album.